Hi, this is Sandra from the blog Cherry Heart. I've no idea what episode number this is, so we'll just say welcome to the latest episode. Thank you for being here. Thank you to anyone who's new, because I've got a few new subscribers that have come over. I think probably from Little Bobbins, because Danny kindly mentioned me on her podcast. So thank you for coming over and giving me a try, and thank you for everyone who's come back. I blog at Cherry Heart, so you can find the show notes there, and I'm also on Instagram and Ravelry as Sandra Cherry HRT on Instagram, and just Cherry Heart on Ravelry. So if you want to find me, that's where to go. Today, let's start. Where should we begin? I've no idea. Not very well planned out today. Let's start with finished objects. That's what we should start with, isn't it? Oh, this is going so well. Okay, finished objects. The first one, let's talk about something you know about, at least. That I've at least talked about before, so there's some continuity. I was talking about some Misty Alpaca yarn that I had, and I wasn't sure whether to do socks or mitts. And I went for mitts. So I'll come in. So you can see them fabulous colours. And I kept the little, what's the word? Contrasting, yeah, I kept a contrasting colour on the tops and bottoms. Just for, I don't know, a bit of interest. I just like the way the colours sort of seem to pop out more against like the neutral. It made them sort of stand out more. So there they go, there they are on. So I'm quite happy with those, lovely and soft. But yeah, I couldn't bear in the end to make them into socks and hide these lovely colours away, so I thought let's keep them out in the open. So that's what I did. So instead, I placed an order. Instead of making socks with these, I placed an order with Maya at the Wool Barn. And I ordered a sock blank. Now this should go in sort of the incoming lovely goodies to show you, but I'm going to do it now because I've already knit the socks from it. So. Finding it really hard not to look down at my computer so I can actually see what I'm doing, where I should be looking at you and you're a bit higher. It's the new setup, I'm still not used to it. Yeah, so anyway, where were we? Sock blanks. Yeah, I've never tried one before. So when I saw Maya had them though, she had some really cute ones. So this is the one I got. I'm not sure what they're called. But it's got all these hearts and things on it, and little speckles. I just thought that was quite cute. I thought it might be quite a nice thing to try. So when it came, because it had hearts on it, and it was February, I thought, wouldn't these be nice to be my February socks for the Box of Socks cow that Kristen of Yarngasm is running, as you are probably well aware. So I knit up these from that, and these are the Skedaddle socks, which are by Lena from A Wee Bit Knitty, the podcast. I can't, oh, you can't really see that, can you? Hang on, let's try it from this way. Ooh, coming in. I'll take it off and show you in a second. There's a nice detail along the back here, which the camera isn't picking up because it's a bit close to the light. But the rest is sort of plain, so it's quite nice and quick. It's got a twisted rib, which I kept too, because I hadn't done one for a while, so I thought it would be a nice change. Keep still, Sandra, people can't see. Yeah, that's better, isn't it? That shows up quite nicely. Yeah, so that's how it comes out. You sort of get these little dashes of colour. This was the first one I did, actually. And I did debate whether to sort of take some of this cream off at the top and get straight into the colour, but I thought I'd just go with it as is. Oh, I can't seem to... can't centre on the camera this week. And it's got a square heel, which I think I might have done once before. And it's also got a rounded toe. So that means instead of just coming in at the sides, as you normally would, and decreasing, there's a couple of other points where it comes in. I really liked that. I liked that it was easy to do. I liked that it was much easier to get the right fit, because I think... just thinking if this is a free pattern or not. Let's just assume for a minute it's not, just in case, so I don't give anything away. But I like the way that Lena tells you, you know, when to start the toe and how to know you're in the right place, and that worked out well, so I was pleased with that. So I may use that one again. Let's take this off now so you can see the back. It's just got a little bit of cabling detail. There we go. So that's pretty cute, going right down into the heel. So I like that. I haven't actually worn these yet, other than, you know, just to try on. But I was pleased as well. I've actually blocked these as well, which is a rarity. But because I knit them from the sock blank, where it's all been knit up, obviously when you undo it, as you can see, it comes out really crinkly. So obviously it makes the socks look not quite as even as they would when you knit them normally. So I'm going to put in the show notes a picture of them before and after they were blocked, so you can see the difference if that is of any remote interest to you. But I thought it was quite interesting. Yeah, so that's sock one, and then they sort of came out the same here, but then they sort of clumped together a bit there, and then I got a big patch of red there, so they're slightly sort of different, but that's okay, doesn't bother me. I think because it's so sort of random the way the red splashes are anyway, I can live with that quite nicely. So they're good. I was very pleased with them. They were really nice to do. It was fun to sort of get to the next patch of colour and sort of see how it would come out on the sock blank, so that made it quite fun. And they were quick, and I enjoyed the pattern, so that's good. What else have I finished? I don't think I have finished much else, actually. I finished, sort of, I guess this is finished. Never know whether to put things into finished and working on, or whether to put them into knitting and spinning and crochet, or what. But anyway, this is my bit of hand spun that I finally sort of officially finished, if you like. My ropey hand spun, which, if you particularly wanted to, you could go back and watch the last episode where I waffled on about it a bit. But anyway, I got it plied, and I got it... I didn't get a knitting yoddy in the end, I just used my quilting ruler. Did the job though. And I sort of wet it and set it, and yeah, wound up like that. It doesn't look too bad, does it? Doesn't look too hideous. Not too disappointed with that. Obviously you can see how sort of fatty and thinny it is, but you know, I guess that's to be expected for a first go. So yeah, so I've moved on to a new bit of spinning. I'd like to talk to you a little bit about that. I'll go get it, because I didn't get it out beforehand. Wait there. Okay, I'm back with my new bit of spinning. So, the reason I got into spinning at all was because at Fibre East, I came across Spin City UK's stall and just fell in love with everything she had on it, and it was just full of beauties. She's very clever, Louise, who runs Spin City. And she makes beautiful things, beautiful spindles. Anyway, so that's how I got sucked in. So she had on her stall a lovely art bat, I think is the way you describe them. And so after I did my little limey basic bit, I thought, right, now I'm going to, you know, launch into one of those. And I watched a YouTube tutorial, which I can't remember who it was, about spinning arbats, and it all sounded quite easy, you know, take a bit off, blah, blah, blah. So I had a go. This is it. Which, let's see if we can get it without extreme light. So there we go. Doesn't actually look too hideous there, I suppose. Quite, you know, thick strands. But, you know. Yeah. As you can see as well, can you see how hairy it is? Not quite as much as it looks. There, you can see against my hand. Fluff and hair coming off it everywhere. Yeah, I'm not sure how I feel about this at all. So I started and I was a bit, I'm not sure about this. It's got all different bits in it. I don't know if you can see there. As well as being sort of colours, it's got different sorts of fibres in it. I think it's got possibly angel hair or fire star are words I think I heard Louise say. I'm not sure, I might be getting that wrong, but it's got this sort of shiny stuff in it it's not really picking up so you can see, but it's shinier. And then this sort of yellowy creamy stuff is a different sort of stuff. It's slightly wiggly and it's kind of on the, I guess the idea is you get a sort of plain bit of combed top, if that's the correct terminology, and then you put other bits of exciting stuff layered on it, colours and shiny bits, and the idea is when you sort of separate and spin it, it all comes together. But all these bits, they cause me jip. They don't want to go into my spinning, they want to float off down the street and not be involved. It's a bit vexing. So at first I thought, oh well, you know, it's harder than I thought, it'll come. And I was half sort of frustrated because it felt like a backward step, because even though that wasn't great, I was sort of felt like I was getting somewhere some of the time. And this felt like, whoa, what's it doing? Why isn't it behaving remotely in a way I can cope with? So it felt backwards, but I thought, well, no, that's probably good, because if I'd had another go with a bit of merino and sort of got a little bit more of the hang of it, it would have felt even worse to go backwards. So I thought, it's good that I did it now. This is a good plan. I shall just plough on through. It'll come, it'll come. So I ploughed on through my first sort of bit that I'd separated out, and that was, it wasn't great. It was all right. There was the odd bit where it sort of felt like it was kind of working out okay. And then a little while later, I had another go, pulled another bit off, and had another go, and it was painful, basically. It was pretty painful. It just kept falling apart, and like I say, some of the bits just kept going off. They wouldn't, you know, like you sort of spin, don't you, and let the twist, whatever, travel up, but it would just not want to be in with it. It wouldn't sort of trap it in very well. It's incredibly hard to sort of get any spin on it as well, because it, I guess because I'm sort of dealing with thicker bits each time, so it's hard to sort of get it twisted up. So as a consequence, I'm trying to twist it more and I'm getting bits that are really over twisted and all, you know how they go, all sort of corkscrewy and horrible. Yeah. So I think my problem is I'm not enjoying it massively. I think with the first bit it was sort of 50% frustration and 50% seeing how bits went in, and that was quite exciting. But I think with the second bit it was probably 90% frustration and 10%, oh, that bit went okay. And also the sort of the fluffiness of it, it seems very hard for me to get the fibres to sort of stay in line. They seem to all sort of ball up and roll round on themselves, and it ends up looking like, it looks like tangled hair, all scrubbling, and then I'm trying to sort of twist it in and It's not pleasant. It's not good, people. It's really not good. So I don't know. I don't know if this was maybe a too big a step for my second piece, whether I should sort of practice a lot more before I attempt one of these. I was in two minds whether to sort of just keep going and sort of hope it will come and it will get better. But I think what I'm probably more likely to do is take this off and go back to doing a bit of merino that's a bit easier. Because I think if I continue with this and I don't enjoy it again, it's just going to put me off entirely. And also it feels like such a waste of such a lovely thing to show you. Look. See, look at that pink. I mean, it looks lovely and fun. So it just seems such a waste of such a lovely bit of fluff if I'm just going to turn it into something that I don't like because I didn't enjoy it. So maybe it'd be better to save that until I'm slightly more capable and don't make such a hash of it. Yeah. So any tips, gratefully received. But yeah. Spinning continues to be interesting. Right, what else have I been working on? So the other thing was my Happy Scrappy Squares blanket. So I had done, where had I got to? This side. I've done this side when you saw it last. So all of that. And then I've carried on sort of adding another block on the other side. So this stuff. Let's just put that up. There you are. So this stuff is all new. Now I haven't quite finished my corner. As you can see, I've got some squares missing. But I'd sort of got to the stage where I was sort of down to mostly solids and sort of speckly yarns. And I want to sort of wait until I've got some more of that sort of thing in. So it's not all a big solidy speckled patch and then other bits around. So I want to make sure the different sort of sorts of yarns are distributed amongst it as well. But I'll just sort of show you a couple that I really liked. So this was my Misty Alpaca Mitts yarn. So it was really interesting to sort of knit with it and see how it came up like that, and then crochet with it and see how it came up, because you get a really different effect. I love it though. Really great effect. And then I've got a few of these sort of speckly ones. This one's my favourite. That's Pop Fizzle. So I got a selection of Pop Fizzle minis from Kate Celine. She's on Etsy. They're really nice. And I did a swap with Sam from Betsy Makes, and I've got some of hers in, so that's one of hers, which I think was Sarah from Texture Crafts, who I haven't ordered from before, but that's a gorgeous one. And this one was Sam, and this one was Sam, and this one as well. This one's really pretty, that one, gorgeous. Yes, so I'm happy with that, that's coming on, but I think I'm going to wait till I get, oh, and actually that I'll just show you, because these bright colours, like that one, and that one, and where's the, oh, the purple down here, that one. Those were my Mothy and the Squid ones, also on Etsy, that I showed you last time, I think. Yeah, so I like how they're coming up as well, because they're sort of solid, but they're semi-solid, so they've got something else going on with them as well. And also, when I open them, because I'd left them in the packets because they look so nice, when I open them inside, she'd put in some stitch markers for me as well. That one's the other way around. A squid and a seahorse. Behave, seahorse. Yeah, so that was a nice surprise. So yeah, they were really nice to work with. They came up nicely as well, so I was happy with those. So I think I should wait. I've got a couple more swaps going on, so hopefully that will bring some new goodies. And perhaps need to order some or wait till I've knit some more stuff up. But yeah, I think I'll wait till I have some more before I go much further with that. I was going to say crochet is taking a back seat for the moment, but I'm kind of procrastinating on crochet at the moment because I've got two things that I need to finish. One of them is like a summer jumpery thing that I started last summer, and it kind of hasn't been weather to be thinking about summery things, has it? But I do want to finish it. And the other thing is a blanket that I started, and I keep procrastinating on that one because it's one of those where I want to get the colours out and line them up, which I'd normally do all over the floor and scatter them out and go, oh, these colours go together on these colours. And I'm doing squares, so I'd sort of set them out, oh, this will be in this square and these colours will be in this square and these colours will be in this square, and generally make a pest of myself all over the living room. But now we've got the dog, now we've got puppers, that's not possible. He just comes through and ploughs all through it, picks them up, chews them, bites them, carries them away. So I've kind of been procrastinating on that just because I'm not quite sure where to do it now. Because I need to have a faff with colours. Even if I do it on the sofa, he's quite good at jumping up and he can reach quite far back, so you have to put them. Yeah, so that's a pain. But I shall get to it. I know I will get to it at some point. Yeah, so anyway, tangent. And then the other thing I wanted to talk about was these socks. This is another Kate Celine yarn. And I'll show you it because it's amazing. It's called Rainbow Sherbet. And as you can see, it's rather gorgeous. So it's a rainbow, but can you see it's sort of got quite a few black speckles and sort of pastely bits and other things going on. Because I like colourful, but I don't necessarily generally like just a rainbow. I like to sort of mix it up a bit or have something else in there. So this hits the spot nicely. And this is how it knits up, because I'm making a pair of socks with it. Look at that. Isn't it glorious? Yeah, I'm loving how that's coming up. So it's 100% merino, superwash, and rainbow sherbet. I said what it was called, the colourway. But yeah, it's just so bouncy and plump and lovely. I know you're supposed to have a bit of marine nylon in for socks or something to give it strength, which I do normally do, but I do love it when it's 100% merino because it's so squishy and lovely. So yes, I'm pleased with those. I had a bit of a dilemma because when I was doing the scrappy, happy scrappy squares, I sort of got to, you know, I'd imagined filling in that whole block and then stopping and putting it away for a bit. But when I got to that stage and I thought, actually, no, I'll leave it here until I get some more, I suddenly found myself at a loose end and no project to do. And I was like scratching around in the evening for something else to quickly do. So that's when this came about. So I wasn't sure what pattern to do with it. So I ended up making one up because I downloaded one that's in my queue that I really like the look of, but it's quite knit purl, knit pearly, or knit slip, but you have to have the yarn in front when you slip. So it's practically the same as purling, and that sort of felt a bit like hard work, to be honest. So I wanted something that was more simple and just, and I didn't think this yarn needed something really complicated either. I think it needed something quite simple. So I just came up with a little pattern of my own, and it's an Elts special. It's quite simple, but I quite like it. I like that it gives it a bit of texture, a bit of something going on without being really very much effort at all. So that's good. So yeah, they are coming on nicely, and I am keeping these in my new bag. So look at that fabric. Oh, don't you just love it? Isn't it gorgeous? I love its sort of retro feel, the colours of it, the sort of the greys with those colours. Just looks really sort of 50s and delightful. Yeah, so this bag was gifted to me by the lovely Sam of Betsy Mex because she is going to be selling them. So you can get your very own if you want to. which is quite nice. Yeah, so she has a shop on Etsy called Betsy Makes, and she's going to be selling these project bags. But what was I going to say about it? Yeah, so I just wanted to tell you a little bit about them in case you were interested in getting one. So I'm using it for my rainbow socks, which I shall put in so you can see how well they fit in. When I recorded this first time, I had them actually in nicely to demonstrate the next part that I'm about to show you. But yeah, as you can see, she's designed these with sort of sock knitting in mind. And there's plenty, as you can see, of space in there. So you could make something bigger if you wanted to. And it's got like a nice big base, so it can stand up nicely. Because I do like to knit out of the bag. I like to leave the yarn in and just take the knitting out so I can just quickly dump it back in if I need to, if I need to dash off quickly. Because with children and dogs, you sometimes need to leap up and do something, don't you? So that's handy. And then her other little sort of thing, which is quite good, is, you know, the needle keepers that you can get for DPNs? You can sort of clip them over to make sure that your socks don't go disappearing off the end of the needles. Sam has incorporated that into her bag design. So that is your needle keeper. And it's got little poppers on, with a lovely lining. And it just sits inside the bag neatly. So you don't ever have to worry about losing it or where did you put it down. It's just there. And then your project just hangs neatly inside your bag. But what's rather nifty, as well as the fact that Sam's incorporated it, what's rather nifty is I can put my circs in here as well, my circular needles in here, which I shall just pop in quickly to show you. Because I much prefer circulars than DPNs. I don't use DPNs very much, but I've always fancied having one of those little needle keeper things to put them on, which is a bit of a daft reason. But yeah, I'll just show you how neatly that sits in there. There we go. See? But because the end's open, the cables can come out the end, but the stitches are still nicely trapped and the sock is in the middle. So that's really clever. And also, because it's circulars and the cable's bendy, I don't need to actually unpop them. I can just whip them out without. But they're still going to hang neatly in there and not go anywhere in the bag, so that's good. So I thought what it might be quite nice for is if I was knitting a lace project, because then I would definitely be using my circulars, but I'd be much more wary of my stitches falling off if it was lace, like I would be if I was my socks on DPN. So I thought that's another sort of good use for it. Yes. And also, if you haven't seen already, I'll just show you that it's got the pretty lining inside. And it's nice and padded too, so it sort of protects. It's going to protect your needles, stop them poking out anywhere you don't want them to. So yes, I was very pleased with that. I was very excited because she brought a few for me to pick from. And I'd seen her Instagram this fabric and I was like, oh, where did you get that? It's gorgeous, I need to get some. And then when we met up and she said, oh, I brought a few for you to pick. I saw that one, I was like, oh, that one, I want that one. Like that, you know, no decorum. Oh, I love it. Yeah. So I'm very pleased with that. So if you'd like to pop along and check out such gorgeousness for yourself, please do. I shall put a link in the show notes for you. So the last thing to talk about, I think, is some nice incoming goodies to me. So what we have is my sock blank that I showed you earlier from the Wool Barn. And then I also ordered from Maya at the same time some more of her alpaca sock, which I think is just one of my favourites ever in this colour. Look at that. It's just gorgeous. This is called Lotus. And her alpaca sock is 4-ply and it's 70% baby alpaca, 20% silk and 10% cashmere. But I just love the little speckles. It's almost sort of like a peachy type thing with little speckles on it. So I really love that. And I've got another alpaca sock of hers, which is quite a lighter cream. And I was thinking these two would go really nice together. And I'm thinking shawl. And I'm thinking it might have to be a new pattern, but I'm not exactly sure how it's going to work yet. It's going to have, I don't know, it's going to have blocks of colour in it, I think. But anyway, I'm very excited about that because I love it. And then I also have been ordering some stitch markers. So I got from, these are Colour Rings by Ellie, which I shall show you. She's on Etsy. Let's go and see if we can get a bit closer. Ooh, tilting the wrong way. There we are, that's it. I struggle so much with this, don't I? There we go. I shall link it as per normal in the show notes. But I got these little stitch markers from her. So I think she had a pack where you could sort of select which ones you wanted. So I went for a sheep, a pumpkin for all your Halloween knitting needs, a little matryoshka. That's not how you say that, is it? Oh, focus, you devil. There we go. Russian dolly. I'm not sure how to say the proper name, but you know the thing I've seen. And I went for some mitts because it is cold and I fancied something winterish. I wanted something Christmassy actually, but didn't seem to be. Don't know if there wasn't anything or they were sold out maybe because it was a little while ago I ordered them. And my personal favourite, pretzel. How cute is that? So I'm going to start using that now I've shown you. I was keeping everything together to show you, so I've been desperate to do this podcast so I could show you everything. And I also got, these are actually, what do you call them? Stitch markers rather than progress keepers, but I couldn't resist them, and you will see why in a minute when I sort them out enough to show you one. Look, the little dash hound doggies, little sausage dogs. So I've got a few of those. They're so cute. So I might just change the rings and turn them into progress keepers because, oh, where did I get them from? That's what I wanted to tell you as well. Because I think I might find that more useful because I'm not really using stitch markers an awful lot at the moment. So, or I might turn the at least one into a progress keeper and keep some as stitch markers. That might be a good idea, mightn't it? Okay, these are by Cat's Designs with a Z, also on Etsy. Oh. Is it going to focus on them? Block me out? Yeah, there we go. So I'm pleased with those. And then I was going a bit stitch marker mad. I don't know if I forgot. I think I wanted to order coherence. Let's start again. I wanted to order something from Molly from a homespun house. And when I went on her site, I realised she did stitch markers as well. And I saw these gorgeous cherries and these gorgeous hearts. So how could I resist that? Cherry heart, cherries and hearts. It had to be done. And Molly also included these little cakey ones as well, which was really kind and generous of her. And she also included some mini skeins, which are in my blanket pot. But she put some nice minis in as well. So yeah, so I was very pleased with that. I couldn't resist getting cherry and hearts. Ooh, that's noisy. So yeah, I can start using them as well now. And the actual yarn, my whole reason for ordering was for this. This is actually a DK weight. I think I probably wanted fingering, but I don't think she had any. But I so like this colourway that I thought I'll go for it anyway. It's called Cupcake and it's on her Dale base and it's a DK. So it is 100% merino. 255 yards of gorgeous merino, which I think I might make into a cowl because I crocheted up a quite basic well, basic-ish granny cowl. And I've been meaning to work it up again. I've written out the pattern, but I want to sort of go over it again, and I wanted to work up another version. So if this crochets up nice, I might try a little test bit in crochet to see if I like it. And if I like it, I might do one in this, because I think that would be nice. But it might be something that looks better knitted, because some do, especially sort of the speckle ones can. But then the speckle ones knit up nicely in my happy scrappy blanket, didn't they? So hopefully it will be good. So yes, so that's what I have to show you for goodies. I've got some others as well. But as I said, I'm trying to eke it out because I'm spent out. So we'll have to go through my barren patch of spending by eking out my, what do you call it, splurgy spending from before. That's what we're going to do. And I'm just thinking, oh yeah, last thing pretty much to mention. Well, two last things. One is I wanted to mention some of the other podcasts I've been watching because I enjoy them and I'm sure you do too. So it's always nice to hear about new ones. So I'll link the ones I've mentioned already. Oh, I forgot to say this time round. First time round I mentioned this. But just because these that I knit off of the sock blank with hearts on, I thought these would be perfect for my February socks. So these are going to be part of my Box O Socks cowl that Kristen is running as she's Yarngasm podcast. Yeah. So I thought hearts for February, it's got to be. So they're going to be in my Box O Socks. So if you haven't checked out Kristen and her Box O Socks cowl yet, that is a good thing to do. So she's Yarngasm and she's in Brooklyn, New York, and she dyes her own yarn and it's gorgeous. I shall hopefully be talking about that more soon. And what else have I been watching? I've been watching Katie from Inside Number 23, who I stumbled across the other day actually, and been really enjoying it. Watched some of the back episodes. I thought that was quite fun. And then since then, I think she's been mentioned on practically every other podcast I watch, I think. So, well done, Katie. You're doing fantastically well. And I really enjoy your podcast. So she talks about her knitting. She's an excellent knitter. Brilliant, brilliant knitter. And she also sews. She sews her own clothes as well, which is very impressive. Something I keep saying I want to do. Maybe might do at some point. Yeah, so that's just interesting to see. And she also crochets as well. I think she mentioned in one of her episodes she was making my Spice of Life blanket, actually, which was really exciting because I was just sitting watching it in the living room. And then she mentioned it, and my husband was in the living room as well. And she said, oh, Spice of Life blanket, Sandra Paul. And we both went, we're like, ah, that's me. So that was fun. And what else have I been watching? I've been watching Mina from the Knitting Expat who was recommended to me by Heather at Pink Milk. Lovely Heather. Thank you, Heather. I love it. So I've been watching that, and she's been doing her fabulous sockathon in January. So that was fun to sort of see her racing through all the socks, making them. But now she's happily able to move on and make other things as well. So that one's quite a good one. And what else do I watch that I really enjoy? It's quite a few, actually. Oh, I've just started watching The Grocery Girls, who I think I found them through another podcast. I'm sure a few people have mentioned them, actually. But they are two sisters that live, I think, Canada. And yeah, so I only started watching an episode last night, but it's one of those instant-like ones. Sometimes I sort of watch a bit and come back, and then perhaps watch a bit more later, and then sort of get into them slowly. And some of them, I just love them straight away, and I think this is going to be a love them straight away one, because I've just really been enjoying it so far. And it also has in it, one of the sisters is Jodie of Mrs. Brown's Bags, which I haven't actually tried yet, but I've been hearing people rave about them, so perhaps that's something else to put on the list. I shall have to have a look. But yeah, so I've been enjoying that one too. So I shall put the links in show notes, because it's always good to spread a bit of podcasterly love about, isn't it? Right. I'd like to spread a bit of bloggy love about on the blog, so let's spread a bit of podcasterly love about on the podcast. And yeah, and if I come across any more, I shall let you know. And if you know of any crochet podcasts, do let me know, because that's what I'm always on the lookout. I love the knitting podcasts. I love that people are starting to share their sewing things on the podcast as well. That's interesting. And a few people do crochet a bit. But yeah, if you come across one where someone crochets, obviously, that's pretty much my favourite thing, I think. It wanes, but it's pretty solidly mostly at the top. So that's always good if you know someone who's podcasting about that. I'd love to hear about it. And, oh yes, and last is just about what I'm wearing, which is my, let's see if I can sit up a bit for you, Victoria shawl. Now, I mentioned this a while ago before Christmas, didn't I think? And I've just been busy and sort of procrastinating as well about getting it out. So the good news is it's almost there. It's coming. It's really close now. So it's being tested at the moment, and that's going really well. I've got a few sort of little amendments to make and a couple of little things to make note of. But my testers are enjoying it, and they've been brilliant, so that's really good. So hopefully that will be coming soon. We're getting close to the end of the month now, aren't we? So I don't know if I'll get it out before the end of the month, but hopefully very soon after, if not. As I know, a couple of you have kindly been asking me when I'm going to get it out, when it will be coming. They've asked me very nicely, when do you think it might come? But basically, it's down to me getting my butt in gear and getting on with it. So yes, I've finally done that, so it's finally on its way. Yeah, so that's good. I just thought I would mention it. And of course, now I've sort of taken the photos and things for it, I'm sort of able to wear it a bit more, which is nice, because I like to keep them in good condition, you know, just all pristine and freshly done. And then take photos and then think, ah, oh, I can wear it now. I can have it as my own now. I mean, it is mine. But you know what I mean. Okay, so I think that is probably it. Yeah, I think it is. So thank you very much for watching. And oh. Yeah, that's it. Bye.